بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، الحمد لله حق حمده، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد نبيه ورسوله وحبيبه ومجتباه ومصطفاه وعبده. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. الحمد لله حمد الذاكرين، الحمد لله حمد الشاكرين، الحمد لله على نعمة الإسلام والإيمان، الحمد لله على نعمة بعثة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم سيد ولد عدنان. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك وحبيبك ورسولك سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين، وصل على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين، وصل على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين، وصل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ومولانا محمد في كل وقت وحين، واجعلنا يا مولانا بالصلاة عليه من الفائزين، وعلى حوضه من الواردين الشاربين، وبسنته من القائمين العاملين. اللهم إنا نسألك أن ترزقنا في هذه الحياة الدنيا رؤيته وزيارته، وأن تسقينا يوم القيامة من حوضه الشريف صلى الله عليه وسلم شربة هنيئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا، وارزقنا يا مولانا مرافقته في الفردوس الأعلى في الجنة فضلا منك وكرما. اللهم عطف علينا قلبه الشريف، اللهم أسمعنا رد السلام منه كما أسمعته السلام منا. السلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله، السلام عليك يا سيدي يا حبيب الله، السلام عليك يا خير خلق الله، السلام عليك يا خاتم رسل الله، السلام عليك يا صاحب اللواء المعقود، السلام عليك يا صاحب المقام المحمود، السلام عليك يا صاحب الحوض المورود، السلام عليك يا صاحب الوسيلة العظمى، السلام عليك يا صاحب الشفاعة الكبرى، السلام عليك من رب العالمين ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته، السلام عليك من أمتك أجمعين، السلام عليك من كل واحد منا ورحمة الله وبركاته، صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليك وعلى آلك وأصحابك أجمعين. Dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته ومغفرته ورضوانه. We meet today on this very special day. Usually this day, Sunday at this time, we have a regular dars with a group of our wonderful brothers and sisters in Rabat, in Morocco, where we are now. And alhamdulillah, today the dars coincided with the day of Mawlid Sharif. Al-Mawlid al-Nabawi al-Sharif. شهر ربيع, generally speaking, is the month of the loving hearts, the month of mercy, the month of the breezings of happiness, joy, felicity, the month of the bliss coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unto us, the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Let us praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this great honor that he made us members of the Ummah of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Let us express our thankfulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for allowing us to send prayers upon his chosen man, upon his beloved, upon the final messenger, upon the best of mankind, allowing us to mention him, allowing us to send prayers upon him, and making these prayers acts of worship, ibadat and ta'at, that benefit us in our life and in afterlife. and having him also receiving our prayers and our salams, and having him answering our salams, especially on Fridays, he answers with his own tongue, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Imagine, you say, assalamu alayka ya Rasulallah, ya Habiballah, and he says to you, wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We often forget that salam is dua. When we say assalamu alaykum, peace be upon you, even in the English language, this is a conditional sentence, subjunctive sentence, meaning dua. And in the Arabic language, assalamu alaykum means min Allahi tabaraka wa ta'ala. Allahu azza wa jal huwa assalam subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa huwa munazzilu assalam, wa huwa khaliqu assalam. He's the creator of peace. He is the one who sends down peace. Although it is a greeting, we say assalamu alaykum like to each other, it's a greeting, but actually it is a form of prayer that may Allah send peace to be with you. May peace be your companion from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the one who creates this peace. Allah is the one who sends this peace to accompany you. So when we make dua, we make our best efforts. But to benefit ourselves, of course, all these prayers upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are meant to benefit ourselves. The same with the salam to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. We don't do him favor when we pray for him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Indeed, we do ourselves the greatest favor by doing so. So the same also with salam. We do salam, we send salam, we pray for salam to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. But indeed, we're looking for his prayers. Because dua al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam la yurad. The dua of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is never rejected, is answered. When he says, wa alaykum as-salam, and peace be with you, peace be upon you, it means he's making dua for you, that your life is full of peace. So makes as much as prayers for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and send him as much as prayers of peace or greetings of peace to him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, send him as much as possible, because they return back to you. And there is a huge difference when you make them or when the Prophet makes them sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he makes them, then this is the difference. He is the one whose dua is answered. On this blessed day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought to humanity light, happiness, joy, guidance, knowledge, wisdom, mercy, law, order, everything that humanity wanted or needed for its happiness, for its success, for its prosperity in this life and in the hereafter. And the lucky ones are those who embraced the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, who believed in him, who followed him, who obeyed him, who loved him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. The more you're attached to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the closer you are to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more you love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the more Allah loves you. The key, if you want Allah to give you from his treasures, honor his beloved sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Honor him, follow him, increase your love for him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And be attached to him. Give him your soul, all of your life, your wealth, your time. Remember that man who came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asking for dua? The Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam tells him, أكثر من الصلاة علي. Do as much as possible. Pray for me as much as possible. قال أجعل لك ربع وقتي. I divide quarter of my time. قال إن زدت فهو خير لك. قال أجعل لك ثلث وقتي. قال إن زدت فهو خير لك. قال أجعل لك نصف وقتي. قال إن زدت فهو خير لك. قال فلم يزل يستزيده ويزيده حتى قال أجعل لك وقتي كله. قال إذا تكفى همك ويفرج كربك. أول حاجة ديون لزمتني يا رسول الله وهموم. He had a lot of debts. He had a lot of worries, a lot of problems. And came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asking for help. The Prophet tells him, send prayers for me. Pray for me. أكثر من الصلاة علي. The man says, quarter of my time, is that enough? If you do more, it's better for you. Better for you, not for me. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, it's for us when we pray. For him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when we do salawat, we are the ones who are benefiting from them. Of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises his rank. And there is no end for the ranks of perfection. Half of my time, third of my time, half of my time, if you do more, it is for your own benefit. You benefit more. The man said, then I'll use all my time to send prayers upon you. The Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then all your worries will be gone and all your debts will be paid off. As-salah ala al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's one of the awrad that are general. You know, for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has 99 names. If you use one single name, let's say, for example, Ya Ghaffar, then you're asking for maghfirah of a dhunub. You say Ya Kareem or Ya Jawad, you're asking for generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You ask for something, you make a special dua, Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-huda wa al-tuqa, oh Allah, I ask you for guidance, I ask you for taqwa, or you mention one sentence, hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakil, you get one benefit, or wa idha maridtu fahuwa yashfin, when I became ill, he cures me, you get one benefit. But with the prayer on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or more literally, actually, or more eloquently, prayers for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, you get actually a full package of goodness, a full package of treasures, gifts from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can use salawat for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to cure ill people. You can use it to pay off your debt. You can use it to succeed in your exams. You can use it to push away your enemies. You can use it for everything. Imam Ahmad Zarruq talks about Imam Al-Jazuli, giving hints of how Imam Jazuli, what Imam Jazuli reached without mentioning his name. In his book, Uddatul Murid al-Sadiq, he says, known someone, or adrakna, he says, someone in our life who used salawat, prayers for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, كان يتصرف بها تصرفا عجيبا, used to do things done through salawat in a wonderful way, in a marvelous way, through salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. So don't belittle these words that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us. They are great treasures. So this is the month of Rabi' where we are, brothers and sisters. This is the month we wait from a year to another to get to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Of course, we have the month of Ramadan. We get with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his forgiveness. But we know that in order to be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to be accepted by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the channel. As al-Imam Abu al-Hasan al-Bakri put it, وَأَنْتَ بَابُ اللَّهِ أَيُّ مْرِئٍ أَتَاهُ مِنْ غَيْرِكَ لَا يَدْخُلُ. You are the door to Allah. Anyone who comes through other than you to Allah will never be admitted. Will never be admitted. You want to have access to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy, forgiveness, treasures, givings, all what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for you, go through the door of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, we have Asr time now. So this is why attachment to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam is very, very important in our life. And when the ummah is attached to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the ummah will just shine with guidance. People will just reflect mercy on the society, on the people around them. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. So this is why the month of Rabi' comes to strengthen this attachment we have to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. So brothers and sisters, I would like to congratulate you. Please accept from the bottom of my heart sincere congratulations on the Mawlid occasion, with sincerest prayers that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you in this Mawlid Mubarak, Mawlid Sharif, time to see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the opportunity to meet him in your dreams first, and the opportunity to get closer to him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, the opportunity to be accepted by him, to be loved by him, to be cared by him, to have his eyes cooled and have him happy with your actions, with your works. You tell me, how are there any methods? We said you can't reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You want to get closer to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, get closer to his offspring. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you access to a shaykh who is from Ahlul Bayt, then get closer to him. Embrace him. Put your life in his service, in the service of the way that he is serving, in the service of this deen. Because we as descendants of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, we don't feel that the deen belongs to someone else and we're trying to help. No, the deen is ours and the message is ours. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left it for us, his offspring, to spread it, to encourage people to embrace it, to teach people the deen, to teach them halal and haram, to guide them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to tell them what's right, what's wrong in their life. It's our mission. And when you send prayers upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or for him, it's not like you're sending prayers for someone. No, you're sending prayers to my great grandfather sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Sometimes I feel obliged to reward these people. Once I was in the souk here, and you know there are beggars, and some of the beggars just ask you for money. In old times, beggars won't ask for money. No, they go in the street doing dhikr. Some of them, they do la ilaha illallah, singing it. Some of them, they do salawat of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Some of them pick up few lines of poetry. And then people just give them because they are really doing good, at least entertaining the souls of people in the streets. Unfortunately, this has changed. And you get now just beggars going around, just nagging you just to give them money. However, quite strangely, I haven't seen that often here. I saw a beggar in the souk just doing prayers on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a beautiful voice. Immediately, I felt obliged that I have to give him, because he is making prayers for my great grandfather. And I happened to be there. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be angry with me if I didn't reward him. You pass by someone sending prayers on me and you are my grandson and you haven't been generous to this man. This is the relationship level we have with our grandfather sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Not to talk about dreams, not to talk about seeing him awake, not to talk about receiving instructions from him sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. But this is the level of relationship and connection we have with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, because he's not just the Prophet of the Ummah of which we are members, which is one simple fact and one simple level of relationship which every Muslim has to his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But more than that, he is our great grandfather sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. We have blood with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. The blood of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam runs in our body, or if you want to put it in a modern way, the DNAs of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam run in our bodies. This is what makes difference. So you want to get the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam happy, serve his offspring. Find someone from his offspring and serve him. Give him gifts, be generous to him. You want the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be happy, learn his sunnah and practice his sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. You want the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be happy with you, do as much as prayers for him as possible. Fill your time with this. You want the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be happy, show happiness on the day of Mawlid. Show happiness. Please put the camera around. Maybe people should see the balloons and see, you know, the type of simple decoration here. Maybe at the end of the session, inshallah, you can show this. I would like people to go back. It's not late. The whole month is a month of celebration. Decorate your home. Decorate your home. Show happiness. The biggest gifts we used to receive from our father, from my father, rahimahullahu ta'ala, wa radiya an, a great master of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The biggest gifts we used to receive, you know, Eidiyya, the Eid money, wasn't on Eid al-Fitr. On Eid al-Fitr, little money. On Eid al-Adha, more money. On Eid al-Mawlid al-Nabawi, the biggest amounts of money. The best gifts on Eid al-Mawlid al-Nabawi al-Sharif. The best sweets on Eid al-Mawlid al-Nabawi al-Sharif. The best decoration. Everything is the best done on Eid al-Mawlid al-Nabawi al-Sharif. It is the biggest Eid in our life, because without it, we wouldn't have been able to celebrate Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. Without this day of Mawlid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, we wouldn't have been able to recite Al-Quran Al-Kareem. We wouldn't have been Muslims. We wouldn't have known halal and haram. He is the greatest bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon humanity, upon us. May Allah make us worthy of this bounty. And may Allah make us appreciate it. May Allah make us thank Him enough. There is nothing is enough in terms of thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His bounties, especially for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And may this connection between you and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam becomes stronger and stronger. And the connection with his offspring becomes stronger and stronger, inshallah, so that you love Ahlul Bayt, you embrace Ahlul Bayt, and you be around Ahlul Bayt, helping, serving, learning, then you go and show and people the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the adab of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the adab of Ahlul Bayt. You teach people Islam. We don't go with anger, we go with love and mercy. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wasn't a man of anger. When people ask him to pray that his enemies will be destructed for the destruction of his enemies, what did he say? Allahumma hadi qawmi fa innahum la ya'lamun. Oh Allah, guide my people. They don't know the truth. They don't know who I am. They don't know what I'm bringing to them. La ya'lamun. Object is deleted here, because they don't know anything. They don't appreciate the treasures. Don't be of these people who see the treasures around them and then they don't appreciate them. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is far from us 1400 years in terms of time, but not in terms of distance to him sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because he's living amongst us. He is alive sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He watches over us. He receives reports of our actions. He sees our actions. He answers our salams. He receives our prayers. Angels report this to him with names. Your name is mentioned, is submitted to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam by the angels with a report of the people who make prayers upon him sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. His mercy is benefiting us now, benefited our ancestors from his time, benefited the humanity from the time of Adam, and will benefit the rest of humanity till the end of time. And hopefully, inshallah, we will benefit from his shafa'a sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam on the day of judgment. We will drink all from his hawd al-sharif sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And we will walk under his banner to al-jannah without reckoning, bighayri hisab. Allahumma ja'alna mimman yadkhuluna al-jannata bighayri hisab. Congratulations again, brothers and sisters. I wanted this message to reach you on this blessed day of Mawlid, because you know, I'm extremely happy. You know, it's when someone's birthday is on, or someone's father's birthday, or your son's birthday. That's my grandfather's birthday. That's the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's birthday. That's the beloved of Allah's birthday. That's you know, the source of guidance in our life, the source of life. Actually, we're living because of him sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. May Allah bless you on this day. May Allah bless you in this month. May Allah bless your families, your children, your mates, husbands, wives, your parents and your family members. May Allah bless your business and grant you prosperity. May Allah bring with this month of Rabi' al-Awwal, Rabi' al-Anwar, the Rabi', the spring of lights, relief to the Muslim Ummah, support to the Muslim Ummah, prosperity to the Muslim Ummah, protection to all these people. May Allah send cure to those who are ill amongst us and amongst our friends and family members. And may Allah grant you all what you wish for in this life and in the hereafter. Barakallahu feekum. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.